Happy December, guys. So today is the first day of December, and a lot of people will say that December is the most expensive time of the year for them, but for me and Johnny, that's serious. And we're kicking it off because tomorrow is my birthday and we're gonna watch Zombieland. I got an adult tomorrow on my birthday. It happens. But we hit tacos tonight. Taco.
What are you reading?
Harlequin.
Harlequin?
She's a doctor. And she has people that are looking for her because she's sleepwalking.
You like comic books?
Uh-huh. Harlequin ones.
Wait. You know, Mama's birthday is tomorrow, but you have a birthday coming up.
Mm-hmm.
What do you want for your birthday?
I want my ears pierced.
You want your ears pierced?
Mm-hmm.
We'll have to see what we can do about that. Mm-hmm. Oh, little red. Guess what? It's time for the percolator. It's time for the percolator. Johnny left me in charge of the percolator while he's out talking about boats on the dock. This is what happens when you leave Kane in charge of the percolator. So, tomorrow is my birthday. And next Friday is Athena's birthday, which means that 10 years ago today, I was getting ready to turn 21. I was very, very pregnant. And I got to sit there. Didn't get to party like a rock star for my 21st birthday, you know? I was too busy creating a goddess. I tell you what though, by the New Year's, there was some partying going on. But giving up my 21st birthday was worth it. Because now, look at that. See that right there? I made that. That whole little tiny human.
I'm not tiny.
You used to be tiny.
I'm not tiny, Tony.
How old are you?
10. 12.
You're not 12. No.
But I
want to
be
12. No, but that would... No.
Why?
Because Mama's turning 31. You being 12 would make Mama 33.
Okay.
I don't want to be 33 yet. Don't rush it. Shh. One day at a time. Jeez. Kids want to be grown already. Some of you might have noticed our donor fender. And it may look like an odd decoration, but on a boat, a fender or a bumper or whichever term you decide to go with goes in between a boat and a pier or a dock. What is different about our fender? Well, our fender was given to us by Glow and Shine the day we started our adventure on July 11th, 2020. And we have taken that vendor with us. And everyone who has helped us along the way, their name has been put on that vendor. And it's our little way of reminding us who helped us get where we were, are. Every name is a supporter. Every name is why we're here. So, to everyone who has helped us along the way so far, and to everyone who may help us in the future, thank you. Good morning. Guess what day it is? It's my birthday. It's my birthday. We're gonna party like it's my birthday. I'm gonna drink Dos Doritos like it's my birthday. You know, we don't give a... It's my birthday! Ah! When your cabin needs cleaning, who you gonna call? Housekeeping! I'm actually supposed to be in Galveston, or on my way to Galveston right now. Jeremy and Bree rented a slip down there. We're all going to get on their boat and cruise on down, see what we could see. But COVID happened. C'est la vie. It happens. But yesterday was pretty freaking awesome. Got my Dos Doritos at PMR. Got to try fried ice cream, which still... Okay, I understand what Johnny was telling me about. It's a flame sear or whatever. It's ice cream is cold. Frying it is hot. It was good though. It tasted really good. And then Brie and Jeremy, they made me a cake. And they brought it to Danny's Seafood where we were drinking beer and celebrating. And that was really cool. That was really cool. You know, I have enjoyed this adventure. And don't get me wrong, cleaning up after other people, it's a dream. It's a dream come true. It really is. But the best part about this adventure is the people. I mean, we've met Jeremy and Bree, Cole and Lisa, Jeff, Warren, I mean, Captain Nick, Captain Tommy, Miss Susan. There's so many great people that we have met. Joanna's up there in the Carolinas, and she's doing good. And we got April and Miranda, and they're gone, but... I mean, there's been a lot of great people that we got to meet because we were here, and that's pretty awesome. And when we leave one day to go find warmer weather, because let me tell you, it is cold right now, and I miss my bikini weather. I do. We need bikini season again, now. Anyway. When we leave, we're going to miss a lot of people, and hopefully we'll see a lot of them again, because Jeremy and Bree want to go to the Caribbean area. Jeff wants to go. I mean, that's pretty much what we all want to do. We're not all going to the same exact area, and the Caribbean is kind of larger than, you know, the Bay of Palacios, but... Maybe we'll all run into each other again, and it'll be just like the dock rats on Serendipity Row getting together again. Hey, Athena. What do you think? You like it? It's a Christmas nest. Beautiful oblivion. Well, try to not put it over the lights, because the lights will make the tape not stick. Yeah, make sure you get the tape on there. Can you feel the tape? I see our tiny hands. Good job. High five. Woo! It's funny. It's December 3rd. We're in Palacios, Texas. And it is cold. Not as cold as it was the other day in Goodrich, because apparently it was below freezing the other day. We haven't hit below freezing, but we're on the water, so it be cold. Arr, shiver me timbers, matey. And every time that wind blows, all I can think is I can't wait to be in the Caribbean. Warm weather, bikini all year long. Yes, please. I'm recording what it looks like when the boat is all torn apart. But I missed the bilges being open.
Well, they're going to be open back up here shortly, but
as you can see, the boat is tore apart. Working on wiring, bilge pump. All that stuff is really important when you're not at the dock, so we gotta take care of it while we're at the dock. Well, Daddy has the salon all tore apart. Athena's doing her homework in the V berth.
Como se llama Bonita?
You heard about Skillshare yet? If you haven't, it's a great place to learn Spanish, work on your editing skills. You name it, they got a class for it. And History Rats just happens to have a promo where you can click on the link in the description below and you'll get a free trial of Skillshare on us. Check it out.
I created my own prison. Should have been there on a Sunday morning, banging my head. No time for mourning, ain't got no time.
So, I still don't have a sewing machine yet, which I'm still looking for because it would help us to make money when we get away from the dock. I can make canopies, bimini top covers, sails, cushion covers, settee, slide overs, you name it, I can make it. I don't have one yet, but Johnny and I made curtains. These are our fancy dancy curtains. And like I said, I don't have a sewing machine yet, so I just took the fabric and folded it together and used safety pins on a string, but they'll do for now. Wires everywhere, but not the one we need.
I really thought about it. I was like, I started doing some research. Yeah. You literally could not walk
spoiled
through here just like 10 minutes ago.
Spoiled ass.
Really? Yeah.
What are you working on in there?
Wiring. story of my life. Pulling the new wire.
Huh?
Pulling the new wire.
For the refrigerator or for the bilge pump?
For everything.
This area, when it's not all torn apart, is actually Athena's bunk. And there are a little wooden ladder that goes right here to get out the main hatch. Nectar of the gods. Let's talk about pirates. So, everybody's heard of Henry Morgan. We drink Captain Morgan rum, and we fly Captain Morgan's flag. And when we change the name of the boat, we're planning on going with a Captain Morgan-themed boat name. Because it just makes sense. Did you know that Captain Morgan wasn't necessarily a pirate? He was technically a privateer. What's the difference between a pirate and a privateer? Papers. Privateers had papers from whichever monarch they were privateering for. So they had permission to be pirates. Another little fun fact. Captain Morgan did not end his life as either a pirate or a privateer. He was actually the governor of Jamaica. Yeah. The Spanish do not remember Captain Morgan favorably because Captain Morgan was an English pirate, and England had a thing for Spain, just like Spain had a thing for, you know, tearing down civilizations and rebuilding their monuments into Catholic churches. If you go down into Mexico, you can see all kinds of Spanish Catholic churches that have hidden Incan and Mayan art in them. Pretty cool. And now you know. Tag, what are you doing? Let's check on Athena. How's it going? I like your eye patch. And your sword. Are you Anne Bonny? I don't know. She was a pirate. She was married to Calico Jack. Her and Mary Read are two of the most famous women pirates. And now you know that too. There are lots of superstitions on boats. From red-headed women being bad luck to flat-footed people being bad luck. I don't have an explanation for either of those, but the superstition about bananas, I know a thing or two about. So it's bad luck to carry bananas on a boat. But why? Because when you're on a boat and you're going from destination A to destination B, everything on your boat is what's on your boat. If you have bananas on your boat, bananas actually release a gas that makes all of your other fruits and vegetables ripen faster, which gives them a chance of going bad before you reach your destination. And now you know. Serendipity Bay. RV park, resort, and marina has several really cool amenities, from the pool and hot tub to the exercise room. But the best amenity is the laundry room. Guess what day it is? Laundry day. So it's $2 to wash a load of laundry and $2 to dry a load of laundry. And thankfully, they've got this handy dandy change machine, which happily takes my money and spits out quarters. So a little fun fact about American quarter machines. I don't know if this is everything, but for washers and dryers, there is a little magnetic strip in there. And if you use any other change besides American change, because our quarters have no metal in them. So if you put a Canadian quarter into an American washing machine, turns out it sticks in the little magnet, and then it'll be stuck right here, and you have to get the washer dryer guy to come and fix it. Don't do that. No bueno for caca. You're not saving 25 cents. In fact, you're not gonna get your laundry washed or dried. I've seen it happen. Don't be that guy. I want to take a moment to show you our awesome sign. This dolphin-shaped marina sign with the awesome googly eye. It was made by a really good friend of mine, Joanna. I mentioned earlier that Joanna went home to the Carolinas. She's doing good, but every time I look at this sign, I think, oh, my Joanna. And it makes me all happy inside. What is it, Titan? Oh, what is it, pretty boy? Did you miss me while I was gone doing laundry? Huh? Did you miss me while I was doing laundry? Yeah, my pretty boy missed me. Yeah. Athena, what are you doing? It's a pretty cool Christmas mask, huh?
Hola. That shit coming, I called him up. I was like, I'm not buying a gun. And they're like, no, sir, that's over the Mercury Award.
Last time I
was. Oh, yeah. They're standing there right now. What's the guy's name? Yeah, I see him over there once in a while.
The other night, he just looked at me.
So pretty. What'd you find? You found Captain Tommy's rock.
Tommy Cox family.
Round here. We walk. We walk to lunch. Can't do that in Goodrich. Can't do that in Livingston. Dang, sure can't do that in Houston. The towns have privileges.
What?
If my
guy
is
too
good.
Yeah, that's still tough. That's a cast iron. It'll hold it for a minute.
Be jealous. My dock neighbors are way better than your dock neighbors. Way better. No competition. I win. No más dulcerita. Very, very drunk, Johnny. Very, very drunk. Oh my goodness. He making all kinds of jokes. So many, many, many jokes. No mas dulceritas. Just paid once, I paid twice, I paid four times. No mas dulceritas for the Johnny and the Jeremy. No mas. Very, very drunk. Very drunk. No understanding. I'm gonna sober up and say no. We can't have these videos. This could be too late. It's gonna be a little too late. They could be on my YouTube videos. You enjoy. When it comes time to fill our water, these are our water tanks. See the line where it says that's how much water we have. And if you listen, you can probably hear. You can probably hear the water coming in.
First tank. We're like a third of the way from being full on the first tank. There's water going into the little valley. There's water going into the little valley. Yeah. In between the two. It's starting to. Yeah, it's filling up. Yes. Hurry. Thank you.
well. And they said water beds went out. Oh no. Oh no. Okay, so it don't go straight into the bilge pump. It goes onto the floor. Getting to our light. Johnny comes in and says, "What are you doing?" And he laughs when I say, "Then our waterbed is attacking our lights." That sound? That is our bilge pump, and it kicked on automatically! Yay! Oh, Christmas mast, oh, Christmas mast, your leaves will never fall off. Da 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 da. We gotta make up more words for the song. That'll just about do it for this week. Thanks for watching the video. If you liked what you saw, remember to hit the thumbs up button down below. If you haven't already, subscribe to the History Rat channel and ring a ding ding that notification bell. That way you get a notification every time we upload a video and you don't have to wait for me to post it on Dark History with the History Rats on Facebook. Oh, and check out my LaSalle shirt that came from the City by the Bay Museum. Awesome place. If you come to Palacios, make sure you check it out. We'll see you next week. Bye.